Ediyot Perek Gimel Mishnah Yud Aleph, 11th Mishnah, 3rd chapter of Ediyot. So in our last Mishnah, we learned three things Rabbi Gamliel was machmir like Beit Shammai. So the Mishnah continued and says, Afu Amar, even Rabbi Gamliel also said, Shlosha Dvarim L'Hakel, three things, three items that were lenient. One, Mechabdim Bein Amitot, you're allowed to sweep between the beds, the mattresses, we'll see. Umenichin Et HaMugmar B'Yom Tov, you're allowed to place the mugmar, the incense, the frankincense, on the fire on Yom Tov. But Osim Gidili Mikulas Belele Psachim. Gidi is a goat, Mikulas. We'll see what that is. Mikulas is it was roasted on the fire in a certain way on Psachim. The Chachamim Osim. And in each of the three cases, Rabbi Gamliel was lenient, the Chachamim prohibited. So what is Mechabdim Bein Amitot? So they would eat. They would lean on these low cushions. Okay, when they ate. So what's the problem of sweeping? So remember, their floors were dirt floors. Okay, the Rabbanan or Oser, kibud sweeping, mishum ashvuye gumo. If you have little indentations or crevices in your floor, when you swept, you would smooth out the floors. The Chacham said that's prohibited. Ashvuye gumo. And putting on mugmar on Yom Tov, putting the frankincense on Yom Tov. So now you're allowed to cook things. But the issue about cooking is Chacham only permitted things that are tzorech l'chol nefesh. Davar hashaveh l'chol nefesh is the halachic term that we use. Okay, meaning you're only allowed to do it as something that everybody did. Okay, but not everybody needed the incense on Yom Tov. You need your special spices and have your sweet smells in your house. Not everybody did it. So Chachamim said that even though theoretically it's really just cooking on Yom Tov, which is permitted, it has to be shaveh l'chol nefesh. And this is not shaveh l'chol nefesh. Only rich people or kind of finicky people or what have you. So they didn't permit it. Gedim mekulas. What's gedim mekulas? It was a roasted goat, gdi, and its innards were like wrapped around it in a specific way. Mikulas, it's like adorned. Kigibur, it's like adorned with its weapons, but here it's like adorned with its guts, with the kishkas on the outside. The Mishnah says they would roast this goat, zechel pesach. They couldn't have the korban pesach. So they would make ki'ilu a korban pesach, an imitation korban pesach. Chachamim prohibited, and we pass it like the Chachamim. Why? B'mnei shenir aki ochel kachim achuz. We're so machmir. It's as if you're eating kachim a korban outside the Beit HaMikdash. You can't offer a fake korban pesach. We don't offer anything that even is roasted. We don't even eat roasted food on Pesach night. We pass it like the Chachamim who prohibit. Okay, and we'll see mechabdi ben amitot about sweeping. We're going to see in the next Mishnah another extension of that. Why we're afraid of Ashvuye Guma, even if you're just sweeping the floor. Stop here and dedicate our learning. Remember my father, Av Simcha, and he's not calm.